In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Hearty welcome to the Eucharist on this the 21st Sunday of the year. Happy to be with you once again. I've been a little busy again unexpectedly. Just returned from the consecration of a new bishop in North India, Allahabad. Our dear Bishop Louis Mascarenhas was ordained. I just returned day before yesterday after a very beautiful ceremony. Today is the 21st Sunday of the year, and we continue our journey with Jesus. And the gospel today is in Caesarea Philippi. The symbolism and everything in the gospel that we hear, in the scripture that we hear, is for us to dwell deeper. And the very challenging question which Jesus says to Peter, he says to me and to each one of you, who do you say I am? And that may be something that each one of us should reflect on today, tomorrow, this week, and right through our lives. Who do you say I am? Let's begin this Eucharistic sacrifice, my sisters and brothers, putting ourselves in God's presence, asking His forgiveness for our sins. So we humbly say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have grievously sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let's all together now praise God in the words of the Gloria.
Peace to people of good.
Let us pray.
O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command, to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Kindly sit for the readings.
A reading from the book of Prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to Shebna, who is over the household, I will trust you from your office, and you will be pulled down from your station. In that day, I will call my servant Eliakim, the son of Hilkiah, and I will clothe him with your robe, and I will bind him your sash on him, and will commit your authority to his hand. And he shall be a father to the inhabitants of Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. And I will place on his shoulder the key of the house of David. He shall open and none shall shut, and he shall shut and none shall open, and I will fasten him like a peg in a secure place, and he will become a throne of honor to his father's house. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the psalm, our response is, O Lord, your merciful love is eternal. Discard not the work of your hands. Please repeat.
O Lord, your merciful love is eternal. Discard not the work of your hands.
I thank you, Lord, with all my heart. You have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I praise you. I bow down towards your holy temple. Our response.
O Lord, your merciful love is eternal. Discard not the work of your hands.
I give thanks to your name for your merciful love and your faithfulness. You have exalted your name over all. On the day I called, you answered me. You increased the strength of my soul. Our response.
O Lord, your merciful love is eternal. Discard not the work of your hands.
The Lord is high, yet he looks on the lowly, and haughty he knows from afar. O Lord, your merciful love is eternal. Discard not the work of your hands. A response.
O Lord, your merciful love is eternal. Discard not the work of your hands.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. O the depth of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God, how unsearchable are his judgments and inscrutable his ways. For who has known the mind of the Lord, and who has been his counselor? Or who has given a gift to him that he might be repaid? For from him and through him and to him are all things. To him be glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly stand for the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. You are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" And they said, "Some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." And he said to them, "But who do you say I am?" Simon Peter replied, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered him, "Blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jona, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." Then he strictly charged the disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, my dear youth in a special way, religious sisters in your congregations attending this Mass, friends all over in this archdiocese, this country, and also other countries of the world. I want to say how happy I was to meet so many people when I just returned day before yesterday from the Diocese of Allahabad, city of Prayagraj, where I met so many people who have been following the Mass during the pandemic daily, and now on Sundays. Similarly, when I went to Jaipur to ordain the bishop there, with many people there who were also. So greetings to all of you, and we form one family in faith, as it were. I want to share with you a few reflections on today's gospel. Every gospel is full of rich of meanings, rich of symbolism, rich of messages. And taking different aspects of the gospel passage, this is Matthew 16, 13 to 20. I invite you, many of you, afterwards to again read this passage in your free time this evening or during the course of the week again, to reflect and see on the key question, who do you say I am? That's a question Jesus asked Peter, and through Peter, each one of us, and it's up to us to respond today and every day of our lives. Jesus went to Caesarea Philippi. Now, symbolism, I'm just sharing with you a little symbolism of these different things. Caesarea Philippi was a place where Caesarea, it was named after the ruler there, the son of one of the sons of Herod, Philip, and therefore Caesarea, the town was renamed, but it was earlier called, they say, Banias and different names. It was a place where there were a lot of temples. It is thought to be the place where really the river Jordan originated. There's a cave there, and they think that the god Pan, he was adored, nature god, and there's a grotto for him, and one of the emperors built a temple for him. Side of it is another temple built to Augustus, and then there were many temples to Baal and to Zeus, etc. And it was a place with lots of religious pilgrimage place, shall we say, lots of adoration, different gods. And Jesus was come to fulfill everything. And now he chooses this place to say, what do people say about me, Son of Man, that in that Aramaic, Hebrew context meant me? What do people say? And the disciples told him some John the Baptist. Remember, Herod had thought that John the Baptist executed and Jesus has come back. reincarnation. Some said Elijah, is it? Elijah was the greatest prophet, so very great credit is one of the great, equal to the greatest prophet. Jeremiah, somebody approaching the kingdom of God, one of the prophets. Jesus is not satisfied, and now he asks the crucial question, who do you say I am? Again, symbolism, the one who replies is Simon Peter. Everybody must have been silent. What do you say? And Simon Peter's reply, we hear, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And then Jesus, symbolism, says, changes his name. Again, a great symbolism. Whenever a name was changed means something important, a new assignment is given. Abraham became Abraham. And similarly, we have people whose names were changed. Jacob became Israel. When names are changed, Peter was Simon before, Simon Bar-Jonah becomes Peter. Peter, which means a rock. So he's going to be given a new responsibility in the apostle. And Jesus says, this revelation has come to you not from flesh and blood, from human sources, but from God himself. So Jesus recognizes, because Peter is the one against symbolism, he's the leader. Again, symbolism, I will give you the keys of the kingdom. So on you I will build the church. The name Peter, Petra, means rock. So in English, really the word rock would be like, you are a rock, and on this rock, there was a pun on this name which is being given to Simon. It's called Peter, and we all know him as Peter. And the gates of heaven will not hell will not prevail against you. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Again, symbolism of the authority. And then at the end, Jesus says, don't tell anybody that I am the, he admits that he's the Christ, but don't tell anybody. Jesus often has told that. After this transfiguration also, he says, don't tell anybody what you've seen until the Son of Man is risen. And if you, not clear, Jesus didn't explain why, but I would think one of the reasons, of course, we all know it's not the appropriate time. Why not the appropriate time? Because people were not, at a particular time, Jesus will reveal himself little by little. I think one important consideration also strikes me. Now, Simon Peter said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God, and the others also. I think he said this without knowing what he was saying. He didn't understand. He was thinking of surely of a worldly kingdom. And the danger is that if he went and spoke about this, he would explain what he understood, that now he's going to be a king, he's going to have power, he's going to throw the Romans out. So it would be disastrous. The mission of Jesus would not be completed. He was going to the cross, redemption, not military power or governing power. Therefore, really, they would surely make a mess of things if they had started revealing things. Coming back to the central question of today's gospel, who do you say I am? I'm reminded of a story of a little child who went to catechism class, and her mother was forcing her to go. She said, no, I don't enjoy it. She did not know much, just her first days. No, please go, you'll enjoy it after a few days. And one day, after 3-4 days, she came crying. Mother, so what happened? He says, in class, the whole time teacher and the others are talking of Jesus, but I don't know who this person, I've never met this person, which is true. The question is, we all speak of Jesus. Have we met Jesus? Who is Jesus to us? This is the central question of today's gospel, central question of our faith, central question of our whole life. Who is Jesus? It can make all the difference to everything. If Jesus is really the Son of God, the promised one, then he should be the center of everything, the one who decides everything, your family relations, your relations at work, your attitude towards the poor, your attitude in your family, your attitude in politics, your attitude towards the country, your attitude towards other needy churches, everything would center around this. But the knowledge of who Jesus is got to be deepened little by little. So today, I want you and I also will do, spend the day and these next few days praying, trying to find out who is Jesus to me. All of us now, catechism class students would say, he's God, the Savior, he's the one who brings the good news, he redeemed us. But what does it really mean to me? What is the message to me? Who is this person, Jesus? Have you met him? Have I met him? We meet him in prayer. So important that we pray. And then all of a sudden you feel his presence in your heart. We meet him in relations of others. When somebody is in difficulty, somebody is suffering, Jesus said, you meet me in the poor. You see him there and you begin to feel that that's Jesus is appealing to me to for my spirituality to come out. We meet him at home, in our the way we deal with your spouse, you deal with your children, you deal with neighbors at home. You meet him when you are feeling burdened. Come to me, all you who are burdened. Take my yoke upon you. You meet him when we are in difficulty. Those are moments of grace. They are painful moments, difficult moments, challenging moments, moments of grace, because we can meet Jesus there if we want to. Or we can just sink into loneliness and depression and all. We meet him. It's important that we establish this contact. Who do you say I am? This is for us the question that I'd like us to post. Is he really our God, our Savior, bringing up the good news, the one who accompanies us in every difficult situation, one who strengthens us in every weak situation, the one who illumines us in every moment of doubt? Or is he somewhere there we keep on the crucifix, on our houses hanging over there? The gospel, today's gospel, got so many challenging things. There's also the whole question of Jesus building the church, telling Peter the gates of hell will not prevail. And therefore, meant in a way, it's an invitation to reminds us that that's my church, he built all of us together into his community. I invite you also today to pray for the successor of Peter, Pope Francis, earlier Pope Benedict. We pray for the popes that they have wisdom, grace, and God's strength to lead the church, to be faithful to the church, and to help all of us to meet Jesus. Sisters and brothers, I conclude these reflections. I want to ask, are we like that little catechism class child who said, everybody's talking about Jesus, but I don't know who this person is? Or are we in our life, in our everyday life, learning about him more and more, understanding about him more and more, meeting him more and more? This, sisters and brothers, will make all the difference in your life and in mine. God bless you. We heard the words of Jesus. Let's profess our faith in Jesus, in God, saying, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. My dear sisters and brothers, God, his merciful love is eternal. Let us entrust our needs before him with faith.
Our response is, Lord, listen to our prayer. All together,
Lord, listen to our prayers.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, the successor of Saint Peter, our Archbishop, Oswald, Cardinal Gracias, all our bishops, clergy, and lay leaders, that they may, after the example of Saint Peter, become real rocks of faith to bear witness to Jesus and his gospel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, listen to our prayers.
For all the leaders of our nations, that they may work selflessly to govern their people, providing for their needs and ensuring that justice and peace prevail. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, listen to our prayers.
For all our parents, that while they provide for their children's material needs, they may also ensure that they grow spiritually. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, listen to our prayers.
For all our children and youth, that they may willingly follow Jesus, the Son of the living God, in the midst of all the valueless and destructive attractions of the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, listen to our prayers.
For all of us gathered here at this Eucharistic celebration, that we may always profess our faith in Christ, Son of the living God, as we love, serve, and witness to his mercy as a church united in mission. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, listen to our prayers.
We pause to pray for our personal intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, listen to our prayers.
Almighty God, we acknowledge you as our ever-loving Father. Increase in us a spirit of trust and confidence in you, who cares and provides for our every need. Make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness with this bread which we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness with this wine which we offer you, fruit of the wine and work of human hands, become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, our Father in heaven.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption, through the one sacrifice offered once and for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you come to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity and even fashion for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty, rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs, one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall,
so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world,
Savior of the world.
For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit, remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Make us grow in love, together with Francis our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, auxiliary bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, all the saints, Saint Joseph, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be equipped to eternal life. Praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, to you, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, be all glory and honor forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now pray, one family, to our Father in heaven, in the words Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, safe from all distress. We wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, said your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
It is always a sign of peace. Christ's peace be with you. Christ's peace be with you. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof.
But only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
We now make our spiritual communion with the Lord. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you, to come spiritually into my soul, to enrich me with your holy grace, and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously sustain, perfect us, that in all things we may please you. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
I want to remind you that this evening I'll be meeting you for a question-answer session and also for benediction. Have a lovely week, and again, see you, some of you, this evening and all of you next Sunday. God bless you. We'll pray for each other. Have a lovely week, and don't forget my question to you, question of Jesus to us. Who do you say I am? God bless.
Sing you, we love.